Hello everyone, and welcome to this overview video on how to get started with the DataSmith Exporter plugin for Rhino. I will start by installing the plugin, which I've downloaded directly from the Twinmotion plugin webpage, and I'll just follow the prompt. You'll notice it detects which Rhino versions I have installed on my computer, and I'll install it for both versions. Now I'm ready to start using the plugin. I'm going to open a sample project. And once I have my Rhino file open, you'll notice my toolbar is already visible here. And there are two workflows to take in consideration: the export a DataSmith file, which is this third icon, or the direct link, which is the first icon to synchronize. The second icon is to manage the connection for the direct link, and the fourth icon, messages, is to show the messages and logging information. To start the direct link, I will need to open Twinmotion. Once open, I can go to the import menu, click on import direct link, and you'll notice it automatically found my source file, which is this Rhino City block. And under, I can collapse by material, which organizes how I want to see my materials. I'll click OK. And now I have to bring in the contents, so I have to go back to Rhino and then click Synchronize. Once I've done that, all the content will be pushed to Twinmotion, and I can go to the scene graph to see everything that was brought in. So this is the first workflow. Every time I want to make changes, I can just go back to the Rhino and click on the synchronize icon to push my updates. The other method is to bring in a DataSmith file. So this is just as easy. You'll just have to click on the import menu, go to the geometry, and go find the DataSmith file that you saved. I already had saved one, so I'm just going to find where it was and click open. You'll notice under option you can also choose how you want to organize your material, and I'll keep it with collapse by material. And there is the content that was brought in. Every time you'll need to make changes, you can just save another DataSmith file and refresh it if you overwrote the name, or relocate if you had a different name saved. This concludes the overview on how to get started with the plugin, and I hope this was helpful. Thank you for watching. Bye, everyone.